10 veces al partido de estrellas, 2 campeonatos de NBA y ahora miembro del Salón de la Fama. You are known for being always very prepared, working very hard. Describe the emotions you're feeling right now as you are immortalized.
This is certainly about more than just me. It's about a culmination of everything I've done in my life, every sport that I've played that's ultimately ended me in Springfield here in the Basketball Hall of Fame. But it's so important to point out that, you know, the people who have pushed me behind the scenes made me realize I was better than what I actually thought I was at the time. And I just realized, like, in life we can do anything that we set out to do if we prepare ourselves. It's like getting information, figuring it out, and then trying to accomplish it. And when something bad happens or when you fail, it's just information. It's not a mistake. It's just an opportunity for you to go back to the drawing board and figure it out. And I feel like I've been doing that my whole life.
Ray Allen has reached the corner.
The three-point shot is something that people remember you, certainly towards the end of your career. Mm-hmm. You did a lot more than that, but it's interesting. You were part of an era where the three-pointer wasn't exactly valued at the beginning of your career as it was in the end. So you must have felt, I could shoot more, and the coach maybe doesn't want me to a point where the show was saying, I can't get enough of your shots. How did that era move? What was your experience within that era?
Well, what was interesting is early in my career, every team had a dominant big man on their team. So when you started the game, the ball always went down into the post. And then you watched how they guarded it. And then you played from there, and we fed off our big man. Now it's totally flipped itself where, you know, the first shot is most likely going to be a three-pointer. And so I've always weird trying to figure that out because I knew traditionally, like, get into the paint, you know, get a mid-range shot before you shoot a three, like, get your body going again. So it certainly is a changing of, you know, the guard, so to speak. But it's just an evolution of the game. You know, the players have taken full advantage of it, and it's fun to watch.
Finally, you were known for your working hard, showing up early to shoot and practice. What would you have done otherwise? In other words, is it work ethic or is it love of the game?
I think it starts with the love of the game because you can't really work at something if you don't really love it. You don't have that passion for it. And so for me, I loved it so much that there was always something in me that pushed me to continue to do it over and over again. And I always tell people that I was, you know, OCD, mildly diagnosed because things had to be in order. Because how we perceive our lives and things around us dictate almost what our brains are thinking on the inside. So I wanted to always present this united front in how I do my business so I can think and not worry about things were out of place. You know, when you're late to the airport, mm-hmm. most likely you forgot something. And so I try to have all those things in place and in order so, you know, my brain can be at ease knowing that, you know, everything is where it needs to be.
Your brain can be at ease as one of the finest shooters in the game and a model for many generations to come. And now a Hall of Famer. Congratulations.
Yes, thank you.
Enjoy the night.
Gracias.
Thank you.